This is another webisode that I call Barking Up the Right Tree. Some tips on how to identify trees by their bark. I happen to be standing by a roadside row of black walnut trees, and I know that summer is coming to an end when I start to see the yellow leaflets fall off of black walnut trees. They're actually one of the earliest trees to change color in our Great Lakes region, a beautiful yellow color. Black walnuts have compound leaves. That means that there is a long rachis, that's what that central part is called, with up to like 17 leaflets alternately arranged on that center stem, so to speak. And of course, it's attached to the branch at the petiole. And the petiole is really fat on a black walnut. And if you break it off, you'll see a little kind of scar tissue in there, or the actual rows of cells that carry fluid to the leaves. And they're almost heart-shaped. Some people say it looks like a monkey face, that little shape that's inside that petiole. The buds are brownish and covered with hairs. They're fairly easy to identify if you get to look at them up close. Along a roadside, black walnut trees branch out with reaching out sometimes over the roads or out into farm fields to gather sun. But in the woods, they grow pretty straight. Black walnuts also exude a chemical called juglone, and that inhibits the growth of several different kinds of plants, especially if you've got tomato plants or plants in your garden. The chemical that comes off the drip zone and even along the roots can be detrimental to the growth of other plants. So try not to put your vegetable garden next to a black walnut tree. So what about the bark? Well, it is deeply furrowed, as you can see here up close, and brownish gray. This one happens to be also covered with lichen. And sometimes if you step back from the tree, you can kind of see what looks like an interweaving, almost diamond pattern on that bark. Now these are particularly big trees, so it's a little hard to tell, but look for that if you're checking out a black walnut. And of course, fall means that black walnuts fall to the ground. The fruit is a tasty treat if you have the patience to open that green husk that eventually turns black and it'll stain your fingers if you don't have gloves. And then you need some really stout tools to hammer open that tough shell. But squirrels have no problem. And oftentimes at the base of a black walnut tree, you'll find the now empty nut shells of black walnuts, and the nut meat inside has been devoured by the squirrels. Hey, be sure to check out all the Outdoor Elements webisodes on the Outdoor Elements website. And then also remember, we drop a new webisode every week on the Outdoor Elements Facebook page. You can find your own outdoor elements when you visit area parks and natural areas. We'll see you soon.